My life, my insights, my podcast. This is D-SPAN. Let's get it. All right, week 9 of the NFL season. Joel is on the line. Joel, what's up?
Not much. Just looking forward to the Badgers going 1-0 this weekend.
Yeah, that was that game turned quickly in the second half.
Yeah, it turns out they got a lot better athletes than Wisconsin. I don't know how many times I have to watch Sauerbrunn get run by Dobbins or some other wide receiver. I went and cut the grass during the second half, so that was
good. That was probably a good idea. Now, did you guys get any snow down there?
We did.
That was brutal. That was brutal. I'm not going to lie.
Sucks. I don't know why I choose to live here.
Yeah. But the good news is the Packers won on Sunday night. We'll get into that. But we were just saying before on the line that it's week 9 already. It's crazy. Going to be halfway through the season. So we kind of wanted to go back through our win totals so far. So I'm going to kind of page through these with Joel, and we'll get some laughs out of them. So the Patriots were at 11. We were on the same page with them. We both took the over. I'm guessing that's looking pretty good.
I feel pretty good about that one.
Jets under 7.5. What are they even at right now? 2 wins, I think?
Feel good about that one, too.
We both were the same on the under on that. Dolphins 4.5, same.
Under.
Good on that one, I think.
Now we're hot.
Bills, we were also the same. Over 6.5, right? Yeah. Yep, so we're pretty good on those. Let me see. And AFC.
What were the
49ers? Let's see here. Niners were 8. I took the under. We both were under.
Yeah. We're going to be wrong on that one.
That one's not a good one. Let me try to find a fun opposite one. I took the under in the Cards one, 5. That's probably not looking too good.
No, I think I took the under in the Ravens. That doesn't look great either.
Yeah, let's see.
It's like 8.5 or something like that.
Let me scroll up. Yep, the opposite. I was over on them. Let me see what another. Colts under. We were opposite 7.5.
I'm still optimistic that the Colts stink, but
I had a luck. I must have forgot this note. Luck injury worries me. Well, that really worried everybody. He retired. but otherwise. Yeah, another opposite one's probably not looking good. Under 8.5 Texans. I was under, you were over on that one.
Yeah, I feel good about that one. But we were spot on with the Bears, though. We both took the under in that one.
Yeah, we were both on that one. So that was a few of them. We can go through them at the end of the year, but I thought we'd take a few of them before we get going in the week 9.
I wished on the Browns, too, because I think I went over. But although I think the Browns, like, they had a really tough start of the year schedule, and I think they have the second easiest schedule or something like that between now and the end of the year, so they could still actually get there.
Yeah, I went over with you, too, but the last 4 games, Cincinnati, Arizona, Baltimore, Cincy. So, I mean, Baltimore will be tough, but I think it could be a winnable game, possibly.
Yeah, they beat them already.
Yeah, so... I don't know. This is kind of fun to go back and page. We'll do a final analysis first week of the playoffs going through that. But let's get into week 9 right away. 49ers Thursday night are in Arizona. 10.5 here. The 49ers are favored by.
Yeah, I think this is actually going to be a fun game. 49ers looked awesome again last weekend against Kyle Allen. The Cardinals getting... A 10.5 point dog at home, though, is a lot. So I like the Cards in this game. I think Kyler's a little harder to pressure than Kyle Allen. So I think he's got an opportunity to have a good game. Obviously, the Cardinals don't have any healthy running backs this week, so that should be interesting how Kenyon Drake does. But give me the Cards plus the points.
Yeah, I took the Cardinals, too. I just think that's too many on the short week. As Packer fans, are we worried about the 49ers? Because I still don't feel that worried.
We'll find out in 3 weeks.
I just don't. That offense just still doesn't scare me that much. But maybe.
They're able to run the ball, which Packers have a hard time against them. They can rush the passer with 4, which is a recipe. But recipe for success, but we'll see. Who knows?
But we got Aaron Jones.
We do. He looks awesome.
But yeah, anyways, Thursday night, tomorrow night, 10:30, we both are on the Cardinals. Let's move to Sunday. Houston Texans at Jacksonville. Texans -1.5.
Yeah, so the Jags beat the Texans in Houston earlier this year. Texans are favored, apparently, in this game. The Jags look good, though. They're able to move the ball pretty easily. So I like the Jags at home in this game. Fournette's come on nice, and the Texans are Jekyll and Hyde sometimes. Like, they should have lost last week.
Yeah, they should have. I'm going to take Houston, though, just because I just feel like a little bounce-back revenge game at Jacksonville. Now, is Nick Foles, like, on his way back? Or did they start
week
to mention
11.
It? Oh, okay.
Yeah,
so it's a couple weeks
out. He's starting to throw the ball a little bit. I think they got a bye week 10, so he's coming back week 11.
Yeah. So you're taking Jags, huh?
Yeah, why not?
All right. So we're opposite on that one. Next one, this is my best bet of the week. Chicago Bears travel to Philadelphia. Eagles are favored by 5.
Yeah, are we going to fall for the Bears trap 2 weeks or 3 weeks in a row after the Saints and then the Chargers? I'm taking Philly. I was spot on with them last week. They won me a fair amount of money. Doubled down on them in Buffalo. Also hit the over in that game, even though it was crappy weather, so that was fun. But give me Philly here, -5.
I love Philly, and I have a feeling this could be the end of Trubisky this weekend. I just think this is a good spot. You know, what Philly showed in Buffalo against a good defense, like you said, in crappy weather, them coming home, they're going to be fired up, and I just don't like this Bears team right now.
I mean, Trubisky throws an interception on the second drive. The defense starts chirping at him. He falls apart, and Philly's defense isn't very good, but Trubisky stinks. Like, they haven't had over 300 yards in offense this year, have they?
I don't think so, no. And the one bright spot of the Bears last week was finally David Montgomery had a nice game. But Philly does have a pretty good defensive front. That's something that their secondary is the weak part of it. And I don't know, man, Trubisky. I know that. I mean, I love it. It's fun to see the Chicago fans crabbing because they were really high going into the season, and now it's been a roller coaster back down into the tunnel.
You could tease this one, Philly to win with something else, and Philly to win, Buffalo to win by more than 3, and call it a day.
Yeah, I agree. But Philly, best bet, I'm with you, -5. Another big divisional game for the NFC North, the Vikings travel to Kansas City, Chiefs favored by 2.5.
Yeah, I think this is a line, assuming Mahomes is playing, which I haven't seen if he's – I thought they were going to hold him out one more week. That division's so bad, they really don't need him yet. In that case, I think the Vikings probably win with a line of +2.5. I was really impressed with the Chiefs' game plan on Sunday night. They ran a ton of gadget trick plays that just got the ball in their people's hands quickly, and it was super successful. I mean, how many times? Well, I guess some part was the Packers' game plan, because they're giving them like 15 yards cushion on the outside and just letting them throw everything underneath them. That's how Tyreek Hill got open a couple times. But I thought they played well. The one fumble is probably what cost them the game. If Mahomes doesn't play, I don't think the Chiefs can win. So give me the Vikes in that case.
I'm going to take the Chiefs. I agree with you. I liked what their game plan coming in to the game was. And you're probably right. They're probably kind of Vegas is probably leaving the door open for Mahomes a sneak in being active on Sunday. But as a Packers fan, let's root for the Chiefs here and hope they win. And I'll take the 2.5.
I was kind of questioning what our defensive game plan was for that game, because it didn't seem like we blitzed at all. And like, that seems like what you want to do against that guy who, you know, if they're going to just have that big of a cushion on the outside so that their receivers can't run by our defensive backs, like, put some pressure on them. It just seemed like we had 2 sacks. Packers had 2 sacks, and that was it. Didn't seem like he was that pressure. Maybe they should reconsider what their game plan was.
Yeah, I was kind of wondering the same thing too. But the one thing that I think we can all agree on is there was adjustments made on both sides of the ball at halftime. It just seemed like the Packers played better in the second half. And as being a Pack fan last couple of years, I don't think that kind of stuff happened.
No, that's because he was busy shooting commercials.
But yeah, let's root for the Chiefs this weekend. But you got the Vikings, I got the Chiefs to cover. Next game, Washington at Buffalo. Bills are favored here by 9.5.
So is Dwayne Haskins playing this week?
I have not seen anything on it, but I think at this point, I think you just gotta start. Well, I don't think it matters, but I think you start playing him anyways. If he's gonna take his hits and bumps, I think you go with the, if that's who you're gonna go with in the future, I think that's what you gotta do is just play him.
Yeah, Bills favored by 9.5 against anybody. It makes me a little worried, but I think Bills have a bounce back game offensively and they cover the 9.5.
Yeah, I'm with you. I think this hits right at like 10. I think this is very close. But I am not a big fan of what the Bills going forward. Offensively, they are really struggling. And we'll see if they can sneak into that. I mean, they're in the playoffs right now, but the AFC is bad. I was going through it. There's not a very good top six teams.
No, their schedule is so easy that they're almost going to just fall into that playoff.
Yeah, I think they're going to make it too, but I don't think they're going to be as highly publicized as they were a few weeks ago after they hung around with the Patriots.
Right.
Next game, Indianapolis at Pittsburgh. This is my second best bet of the week. Why don't you go ahead?
I hate betting on the Colts. But the Steelers, they ended up almost covering that 14 points on Monday night, which was incredible after the start of the first half of that game. I just don't think the Steelers are any good. I'm not a big Colts fan either, but Colts minus one seems like an easy bet here.
I'm going with Steelers. I think the Colts pulled one out of their ass on Sunday.
They for sure did. They have no business winning that game.
I mean, I know they, but I just think that sometimes that minus one is, I mean, obviously this is a coin flip is what Vegas is thinking. I'm just going to go with the home team and see if there's a defensive touchdown or a J.J. Watt big play. T.J. Watt big play. Speaking of J.J., he's going to be in his favorite spot in November on the couch. that's bad. He's a good guy.
That's harsh.
He's a good guy. I'm just going to take Pittsburgh here. Like you said, I mean, that Brissett pass he made out of his end zone was unbelievable that he even got it out of there. So against the Denver is fall tanking fast, and they should just tank too now.
You know, JJ has had all this history of him going to visit all these kids in the hospital and they're sick. How come none of those kids went and visited him? How come we didn't see that on Twitter?
Yeah, I don't know. Now, has he had that same injury before? Was that a rotator cuff that he had before?
I don't think he's torn his
pec. But didn't he tear something up in his arm at some point, or a bicep or something?
We had an elbow injury in college.
But I just thought he had something.
He's had sports hernia. He's had a tibial plateau fracture. He's had a lower back injury. That's probably all of them. I don't know if he's told his pec before.
Yeah, he's all natural. All natural. anyway, so you're going to take the Colts, huh? Your favorite team? You're gonna regret this one Sunday.
Probably. I'll be so pissed. Every time I bet on the Colts, they lose.
Next one, Tennessee at Carolina. Panthers favored by 4. Is Cam Newton back for this one? I haven't really been in depth to that. He is not.
He's for sure not. I guess he's a couple weeks away. The only reason why I know that is because I was paying attention because the Packers play him next week.
Yep.
I think it's going to be Kyle Allen for at least a couple more weeks. He did not look great against the 49ers. -4 is a saucy little line, though. Tennessee had like 150 yards of offense, and they were in the game, or they won the game, thanks to a blown call and Jameis Winston's turnover problem last week. I guess the Panthers can cover 4. It's at home. It could be the Panthers. Who knows?
I wanted to take Carolina here so bad, but it just looks that 4 worries me. So I took Tennessee +4. I think a late cover is coming in. I can't gauge either one of these teams right now. Either the Niners are really, really good and Carolina blew it, but I don't know. I'm just gonna go Tennessee here +4. I'll take the points.
Jumping back to the Colts real quick. So they're gonna make the playoffs. They're either gonna win the division or they're gonna get in as a wild card, probably, let's say.
Yeah.
There'll be the 5 other playoff teams in the AFC are gonna be lining up to play them in the Bills in week 1. Or in the week 1 of the playoffs. Both those teams are gonna get smoked by the Ravens or the Chiefs or whoever else is in in the playoffs. I just don't think either of them are good.
Yeah, I agree. That first weekend of the playoffs is going to be saucy.
same thing with the Panthers. You know, the Panthers back in as the sixth seed, which I guess that doesn't seem super likely anymore. But if they did, I'd be lining up to play them.
Yeah, I definitely agree with you on there. Anything else from that game then? Tennessee, Carolina, you got the Panthers. I'll take the Titans.
Okay.
Next one. This one should be a fun one. The Jets travel to Miami, and the Jets are favored by 3. This is a bad game. Oh, my God.
I mean, Miami needs to keep losing. That should be their only goal. So with that in mind, you got to take the Jets. But, God, they looked bad again last week. 2 weeks in a row. Yeah, don't bet on this game, people. I'm going with the Jets.
I'm going with the Jets, too, but the Jets they traded Leonard Williams earlier in the week. There's rumors they're trying to move Robbie Anderson and, who was the other one?
Jamal Adams.
That they didn't. But I agree. I think Miami is in full tank mode, and they should be at this point, so it's hard to take them to win. But I'm going to take the Jets -3.
Sounds good.
But don't bet on it. Don't even tease
it. Don't bet on it. Don't do it. You look at that line, just keep scrolling.
It just, yeah. And probably won't be much on red zone either from this game. Next one, Tampa Bay travels to Seattle. Seahawks are favored by 6.5. Why is this game only 6.5?
Seattle coming east? No, that's Seattle. Bucks coming home.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, it's not even 7.5?
Duh. I should bet on that now. Seattle's winning by more than a touchdown. Jameis might throw more interceptions than 6. He's been brutal.
He's been horrible.
He's like the new Joe Flacco. Like, he just chucks it up there and just hopes Mike Evans can get it.
Yeah, I just don't understand this line here. I just thought this should have been at least 7.5 or make it a little more than a touchdown.
More than a touchdown, I agree.
But you know what's going to happen? Jameis is going to come out that first drive and throw a bomb to Godwin or something, and they're going to be up 7-0 early, and then they'll be fine.
Well, we benefited of an early podcast last week with Seattle's line was only 3.5 when we did this because they thought Matt Ryan could play in Atlanta and ended up being 9 by the time they kicked, and Seattle didn't cover.
Yeah.
Backdoor cover by Atlanta.
That's right, they did. Yeah, Matt Schaub threw for like 400 yards in that game.
Yeah.
But we're both on Seattle, right? This should have been one of my best bets. I'll put this at number 3, I guess, for best bet.
This is easy money, it seems. Tease this with anybody else you think is going to win at 6.5. You just get Seattle to win and start throwing in it with a bunch of stuff.
Yeah, I agree with you on that one. Next one, Detroit travels to Oakland. Raiders are favored by 2.
Yeah, I like the Raiders in this game. They were frisky last week, too. They should have won in the Texans. Deshaun made a couple incredible plays. I think the Raiders can beat the Lions. I think the Lions might start their tailspin. They've been trying to trade people, too. That Darius Slay was out there on the rumor mill yesterday after they traded their safety to Seattle a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, it looked like that too. I'm going to take the points here with Detroit, though. I don't know. I just look at Stafford. I think Stafford can make some plays with Galladay, and I don't know. It seems like the Raiders are limited still at receiver with only basically Waller there. So that's
What are you talking about? They got Trevor Davis.
Yeah, yeah.
Do they claim Shepard off of waivers?
Maybe they claim Shepard off waivers. That'd be a good pickup for him.
I'd switch my pick then.
I'm going with Detroit here, but another one that I will not be touching this week, I would say. Next one, Cleveland goes to Denver. Browns are favored by 3.5. New quarterback for Denver. I want to say his name is Brandon Allen. I think
Brandon Allen, Bruce Allen, Kyle Allen. A lot of Allens floating around. Did you see the Baker interview video from today?
I did not, no.
So he got a little snippy with the reporter when they're talking about time management at the end of the game and different scenarios, and he just kind of walked off and fired off a couple tweets, kind of the Cleveland version of Donald Trump. But the Browns got to win this game. Guy for the Broncos has never started a game before. You got to figure the Browns are going to win by more than 3.5. So give me the Browns.
Yeah, I like the Browns too, but I wish this would be 3. I just
weren't.
But this would be another, I think, prime team. I just don't. Denver, I think, is going to start to figure out to go in the tank mode too, especially with this Brandon Allen.
Yeah. It's this guy's first game.
Yeah.
Like they're not winning this guy's first game. He wasn't a high draft pick. It's just not going to happen.
No.
So I don't recommend teasing the Browns, but maybe tease the Browns this week if you want.
The Browns did a few nice things. I did watch that game basically pretty fully instead of Red Zone on Sunday. They did some good things, but obviously did some bad things too. So I think that
if you get rid of the first three plays where they turned the ball over all three times, I think they're all right.
Yeah, like Chubb had a good game except for his fumbles, and I don't know.
Yeah, that's. I just don't get why they just don't. He was so hot, and then just sets up play action. Like,
yep.
It just seems. It seems really obvious what they should be doing, and yet they don't do it.
But we are both on the Freddie Kitchens bandwagon this weekend.
I believe in Freddie. This weekend.
Yeah. This next one then brings us to the Packers afternoon game. Actually, I think the Packers-Panthers game got moved to 3:25 on Sunday, which is never good. Next Sunday, which I'm going to. I'd rather be at the noon game and then be home by 7, and now this could be a later night. But anyways, Packers go out to L.A. to face the Chargers, favored by 4. This is going to be a huge – should be a home game for Packers again. It was pretty loud Packer fans in Kansas City, I thought, on Sunday night.
Yeah, there was a fair amount of Packer fans there. I mean, it's the closest non-divisional away game they had, so not super surprised by that. I'm really excited for this game. My wife was nice enough to schedule family pictures for 3:30 in a park on Sunday. So real great timing there, good foresight. It's going to be about 20 degrees. There's going to be snow on the ground, and they're going to be missing the Packer game. So I'm going to be all smiles for that hour that we're out there, whatever it's going to be. Anyway, enough about me. I was really impressed with, like, last year, they identified this week or last week against the Chiefs that whatever the Chiefs were doing on defense, they're trying to put a linebacker on Aaron Jones, and that was a problem. So what did they do when they needed to move the ball in the second half? They ran plays exclusively that got him isolated on the linebacker. Obviously, the play that iced the game with that little out route, but you know, even that little bubble screen and a few other things they did, like they recognized that was their opportunity to win the game, more or less, and they just rode that pony all the way till the end. I don't think McNuggets would have done that last year, so it's a positive sign. And, you know, Rodgers got a lot of love for that touchdown he threw to Jamal Williams, but that was just bullshit. I mean, it was a good throw.
Yeah, it was bullshit, but I don't care. I mean, the guy still made a hell. I mean, the guy still came. I mean, I get that he probably wasn't looking for him, but I thought that was a little overblown.
Right. The throw they should have been more excited about was the one to Kumerow, because that was put. The only place that Kumerow could catch it, and he was on the roof, and he was obviously throwing it to Kumerow. He wasn't just trying to throw it out of the back of the end zone, and if he happened to catch it, it was okay in the first quarter. That was a heck of a throw.
Yeah, that was a great throw. And I also liked, you know, Lazard had a couple plays too. I just love when Lazard catches those little outs or crosses and just plows guys over. I just love that.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just awesome.
How many times have you seen, like, guys try to get cute, and then they don't end up getting the first down? Like, Jimmy Graham had the same play, too. Like, they had him on a little cross where he caught the ball four yards down the field, and he had to get 10 yards for a first down, and he just put his head down and just bowled the guy over. Like, he knew he had to get, and he got there. Instead of dancing around like Shark Fin did back in the day.
Yeah.
It's good to see, and they obviously were successful. The defense didn't look great, but I think that had something more to do with game plan and just not letting Tyreek Hill get behind the defense more than it had to do with giving them the underneath throws that let them move the ball a little easier than I expected them to be able to with Matt Moore at quarterback.
Yeah, and I think that you're right. I think, too, Matt Moore was kind of a they could have did a couple different things. You know, they could have been real conservative or did what they did. You know, I guess it's hard to game plan for a guy like that who – I mean, they just pulled him off he wasn't even in the NFL a few weeks ago, wasn't he? So, I mean, how do you I understand that there's going to be some issues. I think the problem was that they got up 14-0 right away, and then, you know, the Chiefs stormed back, and then it made it look worse than it was.
Yeah, I think they just went super vanilla. Like, they didn't do anything special. They didn't show very much some exotic stuff that you'd keep for more of a high-end offense to try to get them off their game a little bit. Nice to see Savage back out there. He made a couple nice plays. That guy's going to be good, I think, for the Packers. But I think the Packers cover 4. There's going to be a ton of Packer fans there. I think Phil Rivers is going to at least throw one interception. And he's the type of quarterback where you can really get after because you know he's not going to go anywhere. And as long as they don't get carved up in the running game, I think the Pack cover four.
Yeah, I got the Packers here too. And the note I made too, I think this week you just I think you send everybody at Rivers. I think you just
yep.
I mean, Eckler's a nice piece. Gordon, you know, Gordon's been Gordon. Both those guys aren't as quick as Hardman and Tyreek Hill to, you know, get those kind of burner guys where I think you just pressure Rivers and you know a couple interceptions are coming from him. So I think you get all over him. I like what the Packers offense. I think Rodgers could have a nice day again through the air.
Yeah. Just got to make sure that Bulaga, I know he didn't seem like he's going to be able to play this week. And Bakhtiari both got dinged up a little bit. The one thing the Chargers have going for them is Ingram and Bosa with a pass rush. So making sure that you take care of those two guys and then should be free sailing after that.
Yeah, I think four is, I thought maybe it'd be like five and a half, but I can see it. You know, it's a road game in the NFL, so you know, even if it's a heavily Packer fans, they still got to travel. I think I did see that they're going a day early too, which might help them a little bit. But the bye is coming up for the Pack, so they can maybe heal up. Did they say if Adams is playing this week, or are they going to sit him again?
I think he's going to play this week, which obviously helps.
Yeah, and I think you can almost – he can play and kind of not limit his snaps, but you can kind of keep an eye. Because I think we found some good – you know, Kumaro's coming around, Lazard's coming around. And even, like you said, Jimmy Graham looked a little better than he did in weeks past. So,
yeah.
I think, yeah.
Jimmy Graham's never going to be 26-year-old Jimmy Graham, but if you use him in the right spots, he's still got value.
Yeah, I agree. So we both got the Pack minus four. While you're taking pictures, I'll be on the couch. Sunday night is no problem. Sunday night, though, finally a real – I mean, I shouldn't say finally. Sunday night games have been pretty good, but this one's going to be a fun one. New England travels to Baltimore to face the Ravens. Patriots favored by four.
Yeah. I think the Ravens have a chance to win this game. I think they're going to be super hyped. I think Lamar obviously presents unique challenges to defenses, the way that he can run the ball. The Ravens are going to have to control the ball for like 40 minutes in this game. They just run. And the Pats' run defense did not look great in Cleveland. Their strength is at cornerback, and the Ravens do run the ball the best. I think the Ravens cover four. I might sprinkle a little on the money line.
I got the Ravens, too. I think this is the week. I don't know if I have the guts to do the money line like you do, but I think this is the week the Patriots could go down. Lamar is just such a high-level caliber player, and I think he's hard to prepare for. And I just don't know how – you know, the Patriots haven't played the best teams here. This is the best team they've played all year. And I mean, obviously never doubt Brady and Belichick, but I like the plus four here. I think the Ravens for sure cover, and I think they have a good chance at winning.
Yeah, you know, Lamar is kind of like Colin Kaepernick back in the day. Like, you let him use his legs. He can hurt Mike Vick, for that matter.
Yeah.
Let him use his legs. I mean, he's not as accurate or it's got as big of his arm as Mike Vick. But if you use the arm in the right situations and primarily rush the ball, it's a recipe for success. Of course, if the Pats come out, get up by two scores right away, that changes the Ravens' game plan probably. It makes it a lot more difficult for them than having to throw the ball all the time. But I like the Ravens in this game to win.
Yeah, and they do have some, you know, they got Marquise Brown's back this week after a couple-week injury with his ankle. So they got some speed on the outside, but they also got a big tight end in Andrews, and they had Hayden Hurst is like a really good second tight end too. So I think they got some options if they do have to throw, or at least sprinkle in some play action and stuff like that. I mean, it should be a great game. This will be a fun one. Hopefully, you'll be home for this one, hopefully.
The Pats are going to do some sort of gimmick where Harbaugh thinks it's going to be against the rules, and then he's going to throw off conniption, and then they're going to lose, get all off kilter like they did 5-10 years ago, whatever. They pulled that stunt with the offensive lineman, tackle eligible player.
Yeah.
You remember that?
Yeah.
Harbaugh blew his top.
Yeah. Should be a good game. Hopefully it's good weather and everything so we can see a good Sunday night game. Monday night game, Dallas coming off the bye, travels to the Giants. Cowboys favored by seven.
Yeah. Seven on the road still. Give me the Cowboys. They're just better. The Giants stink.
Yeah, I took the Cowboys too, but this I'd put a warning sign on this one for – Danny Dimes hasn't looked too good since his hot start. But yeah, you just never know what you're going to get out of this Dallas team coming off the bye. Two good running backs, Saquon and Elliott. Prescott, Cooper was banged up, so I think he's fully healthy. So I think you got to take Dallas here in the 7.
A lot of times, you know, sometimes in these games, like the Cowboys just throw, they stink, or the Giants do something goofy, but the Cowboys are a better team. They should win.
Yeah, and I think...
Do they win by 7? Who knows?
Yeah, I think this is a big game for Dallas to win a division game, to stay in that playoff race, because I think it's going to start getting tight here next couple weeks, especially with, you got, what, three 7-1 teams, or two 7-1 teams, a 6-2 team, and a 7-0 team, I think, right? I think that's the top four records in the NFC.
Yeah, they got the Vikings. They still play the Vikings yet. I don't think they play. I think they play Seattle, too.
Yep.
So they got, the Cowboys got a tough schedule. They need to win this game, especially coming off the bye.
Yeah, I agree. But that will wrap it up for Week 9. Did you want to hit on the Bucks first three games, 2-1 to start the season?
Yeah, that game Saturday was pretty brutal, 21 in the second half, and not being able to close that out was not great. The refereeing in the first two games left something to be desired, for sure. Some of the calls on Giannis were awful. Guys in MVP can't get a whistle. I think they're coming around. Cleveland was pretty frisky on Monday night. They kind of took care of business there, too, kind of shut that down a little bit. I'm a little... Get your thoughts on it. Their second unit, which is George Hill, Ersan, the other Lopez, playoff Pat, and some other bench guy, makes me a little nervous. It hasn't exactly lit the world on fire, and kind of seems like they're still finding their way on offense. And Bledsoe's been bad to start the year. I'm not sure if it's still because of his broken rib or what have you, but we got to figure out something, like bring Bledsoe in with that second unit to keep the offense going a little bit, because it doesn't look great right now.
Yeah, you're right. That second unit, they just don't have a big-time playmaker in that. You know what I mean? A guy that, you know, can kind of fill it up off the bench. You know, all those guys are pretty good role guys.
Right.
And I know the big thing with the defense is they've given up, you know, over 110 points in all three games, right?
Right.
So, I mean, that's a work in progress. I mean, that seems to come around. I know they were the best defensive team statistically last year. But
some of that's pace of play, too. So
yeah,
they're running the ball, but on the court, their efficiency number isn't as bad. But they've given up more fouls than that's what people have been writing about down here. All the following they've been doing is what's been causing some of their problems.
So. Yeah, I just think it's so early yet that let's maybe check back in 3 weeks from now, 4 weeks from now, around Thanksgiving, and we'll see where we're at. But
got a big game tonight against the Celtics. They're favored by 2.5 in that game, so that should be interesting.
Yeah, Giannis he's going to have a big game tonight, I think.
Yeah, Giannis is going to shoot. Giannis always shows up for the big games, except for in the playoffs sometimes. I wonder why they're not playing Dante and DJ Wilson. That's where, like, I think we need to be focusing on DJ Wilson this year, because hopefully Ersan goes away next year, and that's the guy you should be plugging in there.
Yeah, that's been strange that both those guys haven't been seeing time. I don't get it with that. I can see, especially early in the year.
Yeah, and you need a guy like Dante. He can help with some of the spot-up shooting, hypothetically. You draft him in the first round, now's the time to go. But I've been pleased with Korver. Korver, I mean, they're using him how they should use a 37-year-old guy. Like, put him in the last 3 minutes of the first quarter and the first 2 minutes of the second quarter, and same thing between the third and fourth quarter. He can only play in those short stretches. He can't obviously guard anyone very well. But he is awesome at catch and shoot. I mean, he is... just a knockdown shooter, so that's been fun to watch. I'm glad they're using him appropriately, but
yeah, he's gonna be fun when playoff time rolls around to have that shooter. I think we can agree on that.
It's tough matchups with him, though. Like, if you're playing the Celtics, who is he gonna guard?
Yeah, that's true.
Like I guess you can put him on Mike Scott, something like that. Like, it's matchup dependent. Like, you can't play him against any of the starters for the Sixers or anything like that, because none of those guys would all torch him.
Very true, but we'll figure it. I think they'll figure out a lot of stuff as the season goes on.
Going to the Raps game on Saturday, so we'll see.
Oh,
see,
are you? Okay. Mm-hmm. And Tyler Harrell had a big night on Saturday. I think he had, did he have 29, or was that the other?
That was the other night.
Yeah, that was the other night. You know, he had this good night against Milwaukee.
He also ate a Spalding sandwich the other night.
Yeah. Actually, the Heat are kind of a frisky team, too, now they with Jimmy Butler back. I actually, even before the Bucks game, they actually got an interesting lineup.
Yeah, that Nunn is also a rookie, too. He's been hot.
Yep.
They just, the Bucks defense was terrible on Saturday. There was so many open three-pointers.
Yeah.
But it's early in the year. There's always going to be those duds of games. And you just got to keep plugging away, make sure that you get your cohesiveness figured out this early in the year, figure out what lineups work, and go from there.
Yeah, I agree. Big one tonight. Take care of business tonight, and then Saturday, Raptors will be a good game for them, too. So.
Yeah, I think they're going to get up for that Raptors game. I think they're going to want to take it to them and assert their dominance over a team they couldn't get around last year.
Yeah, I'd agree. All right, anything else from the sports world?
I mean, I want to talk about Tiger, but we can do it a different time. Tiger's awesome.
Game 7 tonight of the World Series, right?
Is that... I don't know.
I haven't watched one pitch of the World Series this year.
Me either. Who cares? I don't talk about Tiger. He's awesome. 82 wins. Ties Sam Snead. Guy's incredible. All natural. No PEDs. Just living the dream in Japan, I'm sure.
So he's been how do you explain this? So the golf thing. So he now, like... I thought the golf season was over, and then starts.
No, the golf season never ends.
But so they play overseas now in these like international tournaments. I didn't know that
it's
even happened.
Yeah, the PGA Tour now.
Oh,
they
it
do,
is
like,
okay.
World Outreach.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what counts. It's great. The Asian swing of the PGA Tour. That's what it's called.
I'm sure he's behaving himself over in overseas, so that's good. But yeah, I did see that. That is a pretty cool feat, though. I know there was. It's pretty good when you see. You always know it's something big when you see Twitter on Sunday with some Tiger during an NFL game.
I guess not everyone that listens to this is probably a golf fan, but there's nothing that gets the juices going than Tiger in contention in a big tournament.
Yeah, that is true. It definitely is fun when he's in contention.
Just throwing darts. I'm sure he's talking crap. I want him. He's gonna write. Apparently, he's writing his own book that got announced like 2 weeks ago. There's no way that's gonna be as good as it should be, but to be able to know the true story of his life would be worth some of my time.
Someday it'll be a Netflix documentary.
Yeah, maybe. I don't think he's ever gonna need the money.
No, but he could get a lot of it.
He could. And I would actually believe him.
I would too. All right, if that's all you got, have a good weekend, and hopefully get a couple of Bucks wins and a Packers win and go from there.
Yeah, I'll let you know how the pictures go.
Yeah, so let me know. Make sure you smile.
Sounds good. Talk to you next week.
All right, see you, buddy.
All right, bye.
That's it.